أفلا يتدبرون القرآن أم على قلوب أقفالها؟
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، فالحمد لله. This is lesson number 15 from the تفسير سورة فاتحة and the قصار المفصل. And today we are taking Surah Zalzala, but like we normally do, we revise the previous lesson. So previously we took Surah Bayyinah, and Ammar, explain the name of Surah Bayyinah.
So Surah Bayyinah means the clear proof.
Okay, why is it called Surah Bayyinah? Where do you get this name from?
It's because of the Surah itself is a clear proof, and at the end of the ayah, حتى تأتيهم البينة.
Ahsant. And what are the maqasid of the Surah?
To establish the clear proof, and that was which was the second part, which is to establish the prophethood of the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and the third one was to explain the reality of this religion, and the fourth to show the destinations of the people on Yawm Al-Qiyamah.
Ahsan. Okay, the first few ayat, 2 or 3, it can be a little bit confusing, but just summarize it. What was it talking about, the first few ayat?
The Mushrikun said to the Yahud and the Nasara that we won't believe your religion because we have not had a prophet, that a prophet has come to us. And then when the prophet has come, the Mushrikun rejected, and also the Ahlul Kitab also rejected.
Ahsan, okay. And, you know, just for time, I'm not going to ask everything, but if I ask you, who are the best of people, what's your answer with your dalil, with your proof?
And the ulama, because Allah said, "Innama yakhsha Allah min ibadi al-ulama," and at the end of the ayat from Surah Bayyinah, and "Innama yakhsha Allah min ibadi," the ones who have khashya the most are the ulama, and he, at the end of Surah Bayyinah, "Liman khashya Rabbah," which explains that is the best of the people, and so that's how it shows.
Okay, kind of. So Surah Bayyinah, Allah says, "Ulaikum khairul bariyah." They are the best of people. Liman khashya Rabbah. Allah describes the best of people. They are the ones who fear Allah, have this khashya of Allah. And okay, who are the ones that have the khashya of Allah? Then we have the ayah, "Innama yakhsha Allah min ibadihi al-ulama." Okay, ahsant. And today we're going to take Surah. Before we move on, subhanAllah, I just remembered. I asked, was it two lessons ago? I said, find out the different meanings of the word ruh in the Quran. What are they?
Jibreel alayhi salam, and the soul itself, and the Quran, and aid and nasr.
Aid and nasr. Okay, aid and nasr, help, etc. Which ayah is that in? Because we've taken this ayah.
It's at the end of Surah Al-Mujadala. وَأَيَّدَهُمْ بِرُوحٍ مِّنْ
وَأَيَّدَهُمْ
بِرُوحٍ مِّنْ
Okay, and where have you taken this?
ثلاثة أصول.
Sorry.
أصول الثلاثة.
Which part?
And when it is to prove الولاء والبراء.
Okay. And which part of the book is that in?
And the second part.
Yes, the second part of it's the last ayah of the second part. Yeah. And another thing, somebody asked. Oh yes, somebody had a question regarding the two opinions of how the Quran started. Inna anzalna fi taqad. What was the meaning of anzalna? And we mentioned two opinions. The first, Ibn Abbas, and somebody said, asked regarding the second one. So they quick search, and it was al-Sha'bi from the ulama of the Tabi'in. That was his opinion. The second opinion that we had mentioned. However, the majority of ulama they go with Ibn Abbas because he's a Sahabi, so they take his opinion. Was there anything else needed to be mentioned?
No.
Okay, خير. Recite the Surah Zalzala.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إذا زلزلت الأرض زلزالها وأخرجت الأرض أثقالها وقال الإنسان ما لها يومئذ تحدث أخبارها بأن ربك أوحى لها يومئذ يصدر الناس أشتاتا ليروا أعمالهم فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره.
Excellent. Okay, so today we are taking Surah to Al-Zalzalah. And Al-Zalzalah translates, as you can see on the top left, the earthquake. We're going to talk more about the earthquake, but why is it called Surah Al-Zalzalah? Why is it called the earthquake? Because that's what the first ayah is talking about. And what is the objective of this surah? It's one, and it's the same as this surah and the three surahs after it. Zalzalah, and Al-Adiyat, and Al-Qari'ah, and Al-Takathur. These four surahs have one general same objective or subject, which is talking about resurrection. So these four surahs talk about resurrection. Or if you want to make it a bit more general, you could say it talks about Iman bil Yawm al-Akhir, believing in the last day. Believing in the last day. And as we mentioned in the Surah Thalatha, the definition of believing in the last day, and as Shaykh al-Islam says in Aqidah Wasitiyah, he says, وَهُوَ كُلُّ مَا يَكُونُ بَعْدَ الْمَوْتِ. That is everything which happens after your death. So from the time the soul is extracted, okay, until you know, until people enter Jannah, everything from being in your grave, from resurrection and being held accountable, all of this is part of believing in the last day. So the first, I'll just quickly translate the first few ayat, and then we'll read the book. إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا. When the earth is shaken in its ultimate quaking. وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا. And when the earth throws out all its contents. وَقَالَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا لَهَا. And humanity cries, what is wrong with it? I mean, literally it means وَقَالَ, they said, but I mean, in context, you could say cries. On that day, the earth will recount everything, having been inspired by your Lord to do so, and we'll go through this inshallah. Okay, so Shaykh Usaymi, may Allah preserve him, he mentions a hadith before we go into the surah. So he says, عن عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما قال, Abdullah Amr, he says, نزلت إذا زلزلت الأرض زلزالها, that this surah was revealed. وأبو بكر الصديق رضي الله عنه قاعد فبكى أبو بكر. Whilst Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه, this surah is revealed whilst Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه was sitting. And then Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه started to cry. And those that maybe have attended some of my lessons before, they know about this fa. And this fa means straight away. So as soon as this surah was revealed, he started to cry. And you can understand that he, you know, it was revealed and he heard it and then he started to cry. فَقَالِ لَهُ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. So then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه, مَا يُبْكِيكَ يَا أَبَا بَكْر. What has made you cry, Abu Bakr? فَقَالَ Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه, he says, أَبَكَتْنِي هَذِهِ السُّورَةِ. This surah has made me cry. فَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. And then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لَوْ أَنَّكُمْ لَا تُخْطِئُونَ وَلَا تُذْنِبُونَ لَخَلَقَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى أُمَّةً مِّن بَعْدِكُمْ يُخْطِئُونَ وَيُذْنِبُونَ فَيَغْفِرَ لَهُمْ. If you, and now obviously he's talking to Abu Bakr, but the khitab is for the whole ummah. The Prophet ﷺ said, if you do not make mistakes and you do not sin, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have created a nation after you that made mistakes and that sinned, فَيَغْفِرَ لَهُمْ, so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can forgive them. Okay, and we learn from this hadith that everyone, you know, we're going to make mistakes, but it's about, you know, repenting about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can forgive us. And we've talked about this before, that Allah, his from his names is Al-Ghafoor, Al-Ghaffar, Al-Afu, and so on, that he is the most forgiving. رواه الطبراني في معجم الكبير وإسناده حسن. It's narrated by الطبراني in his معجم الكبير. He has a few معاجم. And he's one of the muhaddithin, not from the main books, not from the Kutub al-Tis'a, but it's another hadith book, quite a big hadith book also. And maybe we can talk about this later in our hadith lessons. وَإِسْنَادُهُ حَسَنْ. And it is Hassan. So this is not sabab al-nuzul in the sense that why was the surah revealed, but it's still a good background to the surah, that the surah had an effect on Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. So this shows that this surah is, you know, has a great surah. Why was Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, why was he crying? Because of what the surah talks about, which is Yawm al-Akhir and the resurrection and so on. So, you know, these surahs, subhanAllah, you'll find nowadays that people recite, you have people, you know, recite the Quran, recite the surah very nice. You see places in Pakistan, etc. you know, they recite like that, all the people are saying, Allah, subhanAllah, Nari Takbir, this, that. But the surah is talking about Yawm al-Qiyamah. This, subhanAllah, shows lack of knowledge and shows ignorance of the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is talking about Yawm al-Qiyamah. It's talking about death. It's talking about being resurrected. It's talking about sins and people that are smiling, laughing, etc. This is not, this shows the ignorance of the people. And ourselves, we're included in this. I mean, before this tafsir lesson, we would have been the same. We would have heard the same thing and probably done the same thing. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to rectify our affairs. Then the Shaykh, he mentions the surah, and he says, ذَكْرَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى إِبْتِدَاءَ حَالِ الْأَرْضِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what is he talking about here? He is mentioning, ذَكْرَ اللَّهُ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions ابتداء, the beginning, حَالِ الْأَرْضِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, the beginning of the state of the earth on يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, the resurrection. So the beginning of يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, the beginning of this resurrection, how Allah is describing the scene to you. And he says, إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا, when the earth is shaken in its ultimate quaking. Okay, so when the earth shakes, فَرُجَّتْ رَجًّا شَدِيدًا, similar shakes, so it's shaking a very severe shake. وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا, and the earth takes out everything what is in it. What's the translation here? And when the earth throws out all of its contents, and what is meant here by contents is all of the bodies in the graves. You know, all of these will be, they will be taken out on the beginning of Yawm al-Qiyamah. Why? Because we're talking about resurrection here. وَقَالَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا لَهَا, and man, you know, he says, and here they translate as, and humanity cries. You could say it cries because of, you know, what's going on. Okay, people are shocked, people are, you know, don't know what's going on. The malaha, what is wrong with it? What's wrong with the earth? Why is it quaking? And we know on Yawm al-Qiyamah, the earth, it won't be like the earth we see now. Okay, things will be changed. The mountains will have crumbled. And from the thing is, the earth itself will be shaking. That's why we have the ayah here in Surah Hajj in the beginning. What's this zalzala? What's this earthquake that's talking about? يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ. This is the beginning of Surah Hajj. Oh humanity, annas, humanity, اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ, fear your Lord. إِنَّ زَلْزَلَةَ السَّاعَةِ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ, for the violent quaking at the hour is surely a dreadful thing. So we know this, that this zalzala, this earthquake is going to happen in the beginning of the hour, beginning of Day of Judgment. What's the scene? What people are going to be? What's going to be happening? يَوْمَ تَرَوْنَهَا تَذْهَلُ كُلُّ مَرْضِعَةٍ عَمَّا أَرْضَعَتْ وَتَضَعُ كُلُّ ذَاتِ حَمْلٍ حَمْلَهَا. The day you see it, every nursing mother will abandon what she is nursing, and every pregnant woman, a woman, will deliver her burden prematurely. وَتَرَى النَّاسَ سُكَارَى وَمَا هُمْ بِسُكَارَى, and you will see the people as though they are drunk, though they will not be drunk. But the torment of Allah is terribly severe. SubhanAllah, this is what will be happening on this day. So imagine the scenes on this day. Here, it says, وَقَالَ الْإِنسَانُ, okay, that's going to come in the ayah. Okay, let's read it. وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا, and the earth will take out its contents. أَثْقَال means what makes it heavy. That's why he says, وَهُوَ مَا تَثْقُلُ بِهِ مِمَّا فِي بَطَنِهَا, and that is what, you know, what will be taken out is that which makes it heavy from batani. Batani, you know, normally translated as stomach, but what it means in here is what's inside of the earth. فَأَلْقَتْهُ عَلَى ظَهْرِهَا. Now, the earth will take out what's inside of it and put it upon that which is apparent, i.e. upon the surface. كما قالوا ألقت ما فيها وتخلت. This is Allah Ta'ala says, Surah Inshiqaq, وألقت ما فيها وتخلت. Similarly, and it will throw out and it will be free of whatever is inside it. وقال الإنسان, a man will say. Now, الإنسان, they translate it as humanity. In here, ulama have two approaches. What does it exactly mean by insan? Insan literally means, you know, man. Okay? Insan is an insan. Even in Urdu, they say insan. But some, and you know, many have said that insan here means all of humanity, all of mankind. And this happens a lot. And it's Alif and Lam here, if you study Usul al-Fiqh, that this Alif and Lam shows generality. So all of mankind. And some ulama have said, some of the Mufassirun have said, no, here it's referring to, it's general, but it's general, means it's going to include a lot of people, not just one man, but it's referring to just those who denied, those who used to deny resurrection. Whereas the mu'minun, they would say, like in other ayat in the Quran, هَذَا مَا وَعَدَ الرَّحْمَنُ وَصَدَقَ الْمَرْسُلُونَ. They will know that, okay, you know, because they had that belief, they will know that this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised. Whereas those that denied it, they are the ones which will be, they are the ones which will be, you know, astonished and confused of what exactly is going on. I mean, some ulama say this, some ulama say that. You can mention this as two different opinions of the ulama. But وقال insan, a man will say, مُسْتَعْظِيمًا حَالَهَا, due to, you know, venerating the state of what's going on and of the earth. مَا لَهَا أي مَا الَّذِي حَدَثَ لَهَا وَمَا عَقِبَتُهُ. You know, what has happened to it? What has happened to the earth? Okay, before moving on, this is the part where I would say, وَلَا تَكُونُ زِلْزِلَتُهَا كُلِّهَا إِلَّا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Now talking about this earthquake, the Shaykh says, وَلَا تَكُونُ زِلْزِلَتُهَا كُلِّهَا إِلَّا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. And there is not the earth, the quaking of the whole earth, except on يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Except on يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. So from this, we can break it down. The earthquakes are of two types. First type is where only a part of the earth will shake. And that is what is before Yawm al-Qiyamah in this dunya, near earthquakes in this city or this country, and that's it. But the second type, where the whole earth will be shaking, the whole of the earth will be shaking, that is on Yawm al-Qiyamah. So whereas earthquakes that happen before Yawm al-Qiyamah are in certain areas, certain parts, but on Yawm al-Qiyamah, the whole earth will be shaking. And this shows the greatness of this day. And somebody may ask that, what is, you know, and a lot of the times you'll see things that happen in the dunya, there's a link of it in the akhirah. So the link here is that these smaller earthquakes in this dunya, these are one of the signs of Yawm al-Qiyamah. These are one of the signs of the greater earthquake. So from the signs of Yawm al-Qiyamah is that there will be a lot of earthquakes on this earth. And also eclipses and other things, but from them earthquakes. So the link is that these smaller earthquakes are a sign or an introduction to the bigger and greater earthquake. And many things are like that. For example, Sirat. You know, in Yawm al-Qiyam, there's a Sirat, there's that path where, I don't know how you translate it in English, but Sirat, that path that people have to walk on Yawm al-Qiyam. So the ulama say that whoever walks upon Sirat al-Mustaqim, upon the correct path in this dunya, then he will be able to cross this Sirat in the Akhirah. So there's like a link in that sense also. Okay, then the author, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he carries on and he says, يَوْمَ إِذِن تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا. That day, where the earth will recount everything. يَوْمَ إِذِن تُحَدِّثُ الْأَرْضِ. That day when the earth will talk about and mention أَخْبَارَهَا. It's news, it's information. فَتُخْبِرُ بِمَا عُمِلَ عَلَى ظَهْرِهَا مِنْ خَيْرٍ وَشَرٍ. The earth will mention everything which happened on its surface from good or bad. Why? ذَلِكَ. That will happen. Why? بِأَنَّ رَبَّكَ أَوْحَى لَهَا. Why? Because having been inspired from your Lord to do so. I mean, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will command it to do so. أي أمرها أن تخبر به فلا تعصي أمره. فلا تعصي أمره. Why? Because أمرها أن تخبر به. It has been commanded to do so, and it will not disobey the commandments. And this, subhanAllah, is a proof that, and it shows the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that even though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows everything what's happened, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows everything which you have done, there will be other witnesses on Yawm al-Qiyamah establishing or being as a proof or an evidence of what we have done on this earth. Okay, so from those ayat is from the shuhud, from those witnesses is the earth, like in Surah Zalzala. From them are the malaika, The angels, you know, we have the angels writing everything down. And from this, from them is this ayah. أَمْ يَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّا لَا نَسْمَعُ سِرَّهُمْ وَنَجْوَاهُمْ. Do they think that we don't hear the evil thoughts and secrets? Yes, we do. بَلَا وَرُسُلُنَا لَدَيْهِمْ يَكْتُبُونَ. And our messenger angels are in their presence recording all of it down. So it's a proof, you know, we can't say that no, this didn't happen. Everything is being written down. From them is also الْيَوْمَ نَخْتِمُ عَلَى أَفْوَاهِهِمْ وَتُكَلِّمُنَا أَيْدِيهِمْ وَتَشْهَدُ أَرْجُلُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. So from, this is the third one, right? This from the witnesses on Yawm al-Qiyamah is ourselves, our bodies, our limbs. On this day, we will seal their mouths and their hands will speak to them, to us, and our feet, and their feet will testify to what they used to commit. There's a similar hadith here. This is a hadith which is in Sahih Muslim, hadith 2969. And he would say, well, enough would be a witness for yourself against you and the two angels that have been appointed to record your deeds. Then the seal would be set upon his mouth and he would be set to his hands and feet to speak, and they would speak of his deeds. Then the mouth would be made free to talk, and he would say to the hands and to the feet, be away, let there be curse of Allah upon you. It was for your safety that I contended. Meaning, you know, your body is going to be, you're going to be punished for the sins that we have, committed. Subhanallah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala carries on and he says, يَوْمَيْذِي يَصْطُرُ النَّاسُ أَشْتَاتًا لِيُرَوْا أَعْمَالَهُمْ. On that day, we will proceed in separate groups. Now the people will proceed in separate groups to be shown the consequences of their deeds. So, يَوْمَيْذِي يَصْطُرُ النَّاسُ, that is the day the people will head towards, يُقْبِلُونَ إِلَى الْمَوْقِفِ وَالْحِسَابِ. They will go towards the place of accountability. أَشْتَاتًا, أي أَصْنَافًا مُتَفَرِّقِينَ, in different groups. وَمَقْصُودُ صَرْفِهِمْ, and why are they all going in these different groups to that area? لِيُرَوْا أَعْمَالَهُمْ, so that they can see their deeds. فَيُرَاهُمُ اللَّهُ مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ حَسَنَةِ وَالسَّيَّادِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show them what they have done from good deeds and bad deeds. وَيَجَازِي عَلَيْهَا, and they will be held accountable for it. فَلِمُحْسِنِهِمْ النَّعِيمُ الْمُقِيمُ, so the one who did good, he will have the, you know, the everlasting bliss. وَلِمُسِئِهِمْ الْعَذَابُ الْأَلِيمُ, and for the one who has done bad, then he will have the painful punishment. Subhanallah. Ask Allah Ta'ala to save us from being from the second group and make us from the first group. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ, so whoever does مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ, an action which is, okay, hopefully it translates this correctly. Okay, whoever does an atom weights of good. This is a mistake. Atom weights of good. This word atom, remember if you go back to the introduction of our tafsir, we said, how do you tafsir of the Quran? What are the sources of tafsir of the Quran? We said tafsir of the Quran bil Quran, we said tafsir of the Quran bil Sunnah. And from them, I think it was number five, the one of the ways we do tafsir is through the Arabic language. Atom's weight is a new terminology that's come in physics now. Okay, this word dharra is not something which is known to the Arabs. So to translate it like this is incorrect. Okay, I know on this website you can have different translations. That's not the point. I should check the translations. I don't, that's deficiency from my side. But I read it, and if there are mistakes, I point them out. To translate it as an atom's weight is not correct. The general meaning is there, but that's not the way to translate it. Okay. The Sheikh will mention it here. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ, whoever does equivalent of a dharra. What is a dharra? Here, a namla as-saghira. It's a small ant. Not a normal, a small ant. This is what the Arabs would understand, mithqal dharra. A very, very small ant. And this obviously shows how, you know, something very, very small. Okay? That if somebody does a, فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَهُ, that whoever does a very, very small action of goodness, he will see it. And then the opposite, وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَى, and whoever does a very, very small, you know, smaller than an ant's worth of bad deeds, he will see it. The maqsood is still there, an atom's weight. Okay, but to translate it like that is an incorrect translation. Whoever does small, an ant's worth of good deeds, خَيْرًا يَرَى, أَيْ يَرَهُ وَيَرَى ثَوَابَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ, he will see the action and he will see the rewards of the action in the akhirah. And whoever does the opposite, he will see it, أَيَّرَ هُوَ يَرَى عِقَابَهُ فِيهَا. So he will see the action and he will see the punishment of the action. So you'll see two things. You'll see the action and you'll see the reward of the action. If it's good, then good reward. If it's bad, then bad reward. نعم. And then the Sheikh finishes off with a hadith in Nasa'i in the Sunan al-Kubra, which is not the al-Mujtaba, it's not al-Sughra, the famous one from the Kutub al-Sitta, it's a bigger book that he had. An Sa'sa'ata radiyallahu anhu, he said, قدمت على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فسمعته يقول I came upon the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and I heard him say فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره. So the Prophet was reciting this ayah. And then he said, قال ما أبالي ألا أسمع غيرها حسبي وإسناده صحيح. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, when hearing this ayah, what did the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم say? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said that, you know, that's it, that's enough, I don't need to hear anymore. And this is authentic. I mean, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was affected by this. And that's why in this surah, what we learn from this surah, we have learned that first, you know, we should be scared from this zalza and Yawm al-Qiyam was going to happen. And we should do more good deeds no matter how small. Okay? And we should never ever belittle any deeds, whether good or bad. You know, they say, you know, some people belittle bad deeds and they say, you know, something small. But no, you know, we have many parables in the English language. The greatest of fires are made from the smallest of sparks, or the greatest of mountains are made from the smallest of pebbles, and things like that. Huh? Oh, subhanAllah, I'm forgetting the poetry. لَا تَحْقِرَنَّ صَغِيرَةً إِنَّ الْجِبَالَ مِنَ الْحَصَى. Never belittle a minor sin, because verily, mountains are made from pebbles. But that's the last line of the poetry. There's two lines before it. Allahumma sta'in. I can't remember. Ala kulli hal. So this is some of the things that we learn from this surah. And this surah is quite straightforward. Just one last mas'ala is that there's a bit of khilaf in this mas'ala. So I'll mention it just quickly. We don't normally, but today's lesson was a bit quicker compared to the previous lesson. So we'll mention something, which is, you know, Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we believe that there is going to be a scale on Yawm al-Qiyamah. And the scale has kiffatan, it has, you know, what do you call it? Kiffatan, two, you know, there's two parts on each side. Two scales, yeah, two scales, real scales. And it will weigh what we have done. But then the question, Ahl Sunnah themselves, they have ikhtilaf, what exactly is being weighed? Okay, so some say the person is being weighed. And each opinion has authentic hadith, etc. And some say, the books of our deeds was written in there, that will be weighed. But from this ayah, they say that no, it's our actions which will be weighed. So our actions, what we have done, they will be put in the scales and they will be held, they will be weighed. Some people may ask that, okay, you know, actions are intangible, they're not something that we can physically touch, so how are they going to be weighed? Okay, we have two answers for this. The first answer is that a mu'min, whenever he is told something of the Yawm al-Akhir or anything regarding the ghayb generally, anything regarding the unseen, we believe it. We believe it. Okay, because it's from the unseen, we can't comprehend it. And secondly, it's possible. Why not? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there's other ahadith where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says that he will bring things which are intangible and make them into something. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says that he will bring death in the form of a sheep, I believe. It's not written in Bukhari or Muslim. Wait, actually, did I think I got the hadith up? Yeah. Ram. On the day of judgment, death will be brought forward in the shape of a black and white ram. So, you know, this is very, very possible. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to do that with some certain tangible things, and obviously it's possible with other things. And with that, alhamdulillah, you know, we finished the surah, and there's many, many lessons that we can take from the surah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who, you know, do good deeds and do not belittle the bad deeds, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants us a beautiful ending, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes us from people, makes us from the people of paradise. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant astaghfiruka wa atubu ilaik. If there are any questions, I'll quickly take some questions, inshallah. The famous saying is that we should worry about our little sins because mountains don't bother us. Okay. Yeah. So what was a reference to the last hadith that I mentioned? The last hadith. Okay, this was in Bukhari 4730. 4730. Really beneficial. Is a recording for the last lesson available? Has it not been uploaded? Has last lesson not been uploaded? If not, then tomorrow we'll upload last lesson and this lesson. But I'm pretty sure it was uploaded. Check the YouTube channel, inshallah. It's there? Khas, it's there. It's on the YouTube channel. Lesson 14 now. I'm pretty sure we uploaded two lessons last week. Okay, class, I don't think there's any more questions, so we'll stop here, inshallah. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilaik.